Shalom Ras Teferi, Salamta, Salamta to all the brothers and all the sisters, and to all, you know, willing to make their wills obedient to good influences. Okay, just a little quick update. Just as soon as you know, the Torah study cycle renews itself and we go into Rastafari sabbatical study number one, we're gonna initiate the Spanish Bible studies. And I just wanted to make mention, we decided that we're gonna go with the Reina Valero version, I guess 1909, and it's not that bad. We went over some of the key verses, you know, like Psalm 87 and Genesis 1, you know, where it mentions and pass it the whole land of Ethiopia. And just to kind of like check it out, some of those places where the world likes to pretend that Ethiopia was never there, right? And the book of Zephaniah and all that, and it's all right. And if we come across some slander and misprints, you know, and some blasphemy, we'll just throw this in the trash, no big deal. But yeah, as far as for now, we're gonna use that. It's only going to be a little challenging because just like the King James, it's old English. This one's kind of like an old style of Spanish, and it makes it interesting, right? It's the closest to the King James. It was actually written before the King James, but regardless, we'll stick to that. But I did want to make mention that after receiving that, we came across this. It was a gift for a family member, and but really it was a gift for I and I because another relative pointed out that this was given on the same date, 1 year from the same date that it was received, you know. So basically it was given to someone in the family 1 year exactly the day that I found out this was even in the house. It had never been opened, so this is ours, right? This was intended by the Almighty. That is good. For the family of Rastafari. And I mentioned this because this one's interesting. It's a Latino America Bible. And not only does it have like reference and notes and all of that, but it's the Spanish is way more fluent, in the sense that I would be able to really flow with it because it's more natural, more kind of like street, that in the sense that it's not well written or anything, but a more common Spanish form or style of Spanish. But this one I make mention because it's really interesting. Like right in the beginning, you know, where it says that the river passeth the whole land of Ethiopia, this one actually says Kuch. And I had never come across that before. But even more interesting is this one has the book of Maccabees. I think it even has two books of Maccabees. Yeah, it has Maccabees 1 and 2. And then it has the book of Tobiah. It has the book of the Wisdom of Solomon. It has Jude. Well, I don't know if Judith is included in some of the other scriptures. I think it's not. But yeah, this one is full of surprises. Well, at least I didn't expect it. Let me just this one says Siracides, Siracides. I don't know if that's the Sadducees or something like that, but it, you know, and I'm not saying that these are inspired, right? Well, the Book of Tobiah and Wisdom of Solomon and Maccabees, they are, right? But I say this one because I had never even heard of this. Or maybe I have, but I don't know the direct translation. But yeah, and there's like a Book of Songs and Book of Wisdom. Oh, this one's a Book of Baruch. And I'm guessing it's like a blessing, you know, like Beruku or Baruch. And yeah, and this one has two Ecclesiastes. So it's interesting, you know, just to make mention that if all seems well, we might use this one. And then this one's neat. I just saw something. Check that out. I mean, it may not be all that clear, but she's not white, I'll tell you that much. And she's not Mexican. You know, she well, I don't know, because of the hair, right? But all right, now that I look at it, yeah, they kind of threw in some European features, right? But it's, you know, just interesting to note how it's a little more accurate than some of the other stuff that's out there. Okay, this one's interesting. Now here, okay, the fact that he's on the cross, well, you know, Wyndham Yadom's been over that, but this one's actually, he's actually of an Ethiopian complexion. You know, he's actually black. So that's cool. That's this one actually looks like his Imperial Majesty. Well, I think because of the nose and his face structure. Well, that's really interesting. Well, you know, it turns out this one's pretty, not that. Well, it's got a map, you know, I guess. So, you know, it turns out that we're not going to go with this because, being that it includes a lot of different scriptures, and I'm not too familiar with them, I don't want to introduce something that is not accurate, or, you know, I'm not even qualified to say. But we're definitely going to look into this. And, you know, September 7th, it says, I don't know if you... Well, it says September 7th, right? And like a week ago, we opened it for the first time, right? So yeah, just an update. Just wanted to let all the brothers and sisters, you know, just to know what's going on and how it's, you know, Ja William is so, well, it's already international, right? But Ja William, it'll, you know, the other tribes will learn half of the story, you know. So I give thanks to everyone, you know, that make this possible. You know, let Jah be our guidance and protection. Until then, Rastafari.